So we are here at Strathcona High School. The bike-a-thon has started.
Just the energy and excitement from the students across, and again, channeling all that energy and passion into raising a ridiculous amount of money. That's what's just so mind-boggling.
I have to tell you, this is Skona. And Skona usually goes big.
We come together for a greater cause.
You did how many hours on the bike?
We did 7 hours, from midnight to 7 a.m.
I had no doubt in my mind you were going to crush your goal this year. And so
students, teachers, counselors, and also city councilors have been here.
The kids right now in the generation that are in our high schools really want to serve. They really want to give back, and they really want to make a difference. And this is just a huge example of that. Again, I'm just amazed.
I believe this is what education's about. Just getting everybody together for a cause, and I think a long time in the future, this is what you'll remember.
Showing that individual effort, when you multiply it with a great group dynamic like this and a sense of purpose, that can add up to something very significant to make change globally and locally. I think that just inspires people to be active citizens, to want to make a difference, and to realize that solving the great problems of our time, like poverty, is achievable.
$50,000 the kids at Skona are giving to two very worthwhile projects. It's just simply amazing. Congratulations to the Skona community.
So 8 years ago, when I arrived at the school, I knew that there was a culture of service at Strathcona School. Our motto is, as one who serves. I think the number one underlying goal of the program, and really what we're trying to do in schools everywhere, is we're trying to encourage students to become the best version of themselves possible. And what the campaigns and service initiatives do is they give kids that opportunity to shine. And it allows them to work with one another and to work out conflict. And it gives them an opportunity to stand for something positive. There's a folk artist named Jeremy Fisher, and he has a song that says, if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. And so what I think is the fundamental underlying, I guess, reason that we engage in these massive service initiatives is to encourage kids at their own individual level to be the best version of themselves. And we believe that that happens by giving to others, and that not only does the people that we give of our time, of ourselves, of our money to, it benefits them, but also benefits self, and as a result, our society grows in the process. We all strengthen and we elevate through our collective efforts.
Well, as you know, there's been a tradition of doing global initiatives here at Strathcona, and this year we ran into a different problem to solve in that we were at a 50-50 vote for two different causes. One was local and one was global. And so we sat there and we asked ourselves, what do we do in this situation? And we felt that we had a connection to both, and actually both causes had a connection to one another, and that's where the Treehouse project came from. So the Treehouse project is both helping the Bissell Center in Edmonton, as well as kind of transporting ourselves to Ecuador to help Change for Children, building an eco lodge there. You and me, if your son in the sea, oh, let me go.
Because you guys exceeded your goal and you went so far above and beyond what you had initially anticipated, it's actually given us the funding to hire not one but three housing options program workers, which is fantastic. And so they are now going to be a part of a team which will be brand new. It'll launch on August 1st. The challenges that are facing individuals who are homeless are immense, and I think they are a lot of challenges that we don't often think about in our everyday life. So if you are homeless, you likely don't have a piece of ID with a legitimate address on it. So that is going to keep you from getting access access to an Alberta healthcare card, because you need to have those two things together. And it's, you know, it just, it's barrier after barrier. And also, the amount of time that you spend trying to access these services often inhibits your ability to move from where you're at into a better space. So for example, if you are working with an individual who is skilled in carpentry, let's say, but they are homeless, then they need to be waiting in line to make sure they have a place to sleep tonight. So that means they're going to walk over to a shelter and they're going to wait an hour and a half before it opens so that they can get in to get a bed. At 6 a.m., all the lights go on. By 6:30, you get the boot. Between 6:30 and 8:30, where do you go? Because buildings really aren't open that early for you to wait in, and you need to access employment. Well, we've got a casual employment program, but obviously jobs are limited. So then you get that person who comes through, waits in line, and then doesn't get that casual job labor placement. So then where does that person go next? And so your day is spent waiting in line. It is spent trying to get the basic services and the basic needs that we already have met for us. And when you put a roof over someone's head, you fundamentally take away a barrier that prevents them from moving out of where they're at. The need is greater than the service available. And so we get lineups of people who have signed up for homeless to homes, hoping to get in and see a worker. And you know, we try to help everybody the best that we can, but sometimes they get to the front of the line and they can't actually get in because they're not eligible because they haven't been homeless long enough. And so the Housing Options Program is designed to take care of those people, to capture the folks who aren't quite eligible or those who are newly homeless, because it costs the system immense amounts of money for people to remain homeless. It is, I'm sure you've seen the studies, it is way cheaper to put someone in a house and to help them rebuild their life from a home base than it is for them to access employment and health and all of these other supports that they need before putting them into a house. And so Housing Options has worked specifically with these folks who've come through, and one of the stories that comes to mind is that there was a mom with five kids, who was newly homeless, and she couldn't get into the program because she hadn't been homeless long enough. And so Housing Options helped her. They helped move her into a place where she needed to be so that she could take care of her kids, so that she could begin to rebuild her life.
Well, we visited the Cuyabeno region in Ecuador in February, and we saw a lot of the lodges operating sort of independent of the local indigenous people. So all of the food that is prepared for the tourists at the lodges is brought in from outside. They don't buy from the local indigenous people, because the local indigenous people are not growing food for sale, and they're not raising chickens, for instance, to provide eggs to the local lodges, this kind of thing. So we met a lot of indigenous people that are eager to participate in the existing tourism infrastructure that is going on in the Cuyabeno, but not able to participate because they don't have the capacity to grow food for sale, for instance, or raise chickens. So we talked to a number of families in one of the villages there along the river, and said, well, what if we came in and like helped you to establish your own gardens where you could grow food to sell to the lodges, and what if we helped you to be able to grow chickens or to raise chickens and be able to sell eggs and meat to the local lodges. And they were very happy to hear those kinds of initiatives that are sort of baby steps towards a long-term goal of being able to participate in tourism. As we build their capacity towards understanding how to participate in the existing tourist infrastructure, they are then able to understand what it takes to run their own business.
Thank you. each day it is retreat. Seems like yesterday, your eyes crept this way.